This is our tutorial number 21, dynamic list item. The dynamic list item, last tutorial, previously, we have seen list item called static list item. We will type everything in the list item like this. Suppose my list item is there, I will type in the elements of list. The list elements will be appear in the runtime. The list value should be related with my database. That's what we studied in the list items. Now in the dynamic list item, how it will appear? First I will show the runtime. The dynamic list item you can see here. The record, instead of product ID, I can create product name here in the product list item. So this way I can do the dynamic list item. So I can find the list values here. So but I am not typed anything in the list values. That is called the dynamic list item here. The product ID, actually it is product ID come under number, but I am using the name here, the product name in the supplier table. So what are the steps I want to follow for this? That's what we'll study now. So first, to create a dynamic list, we want to repeat some steps. So change the product as list item, that is list in value, don't have any value. By default it is coming like this. So for example here, the listed element, suppose I want to create anything list item, here it will come list 16, here it will come list 16. Remove all this thing. That is the steps I am saying now. Second point, what is the second point? Change data type as character, not number. By default, this is called my, this is my product ID should be what? Number. But I change as what? Character here. And third point, what is the third point? Third point, I will change data item. No, it is not a data item. So it is not a data item. I will change as a run IP here. So this is what a three important point I want to do it. And fourth, another important point is copy value from. Copy value from no item, it should be blank because I am not created any relationship. Here a single block, you can see single block called supplier. The supplier table is a detail table, not a master table. The master table is a product table. From this I am doing all these things. So where I will do everything, I will do in the property palette. That's what I am saying. So change database item as no. Copy value from should be blank. Don't create master detail relationship. If you create master detail relationship, it never take value from the list. Actually, it will list will create it, but no values. Without values, it will come in the runtime. So no need to create data block of product. So no need to create any block in the module or FMB. So now we see the code. How I create the code? Procedure. I am creating procedure here. Can you see here? My procedure is available here. So you can see the procedures. Here I create the programming item, procedures body, procedure dynamic list item, RG name. I am creating which name? This is related to my database. So you can see here my product table. I will say select my product table and I will show the product table. In the product table, this name is available. So I will go and check the product table here. So I will select the product table, describe product table. Describe product table, I will do it. You see the pro name, that name I will use it here. That's what I am doing here, pro name. And this is varchar. So record group, I am creating one record group, number, number of record should be. The record group I am finding this name, that is that my pro name. Whatever records are available in the product name should be included here. If null, if it is null, I am checking. So what I am doing, I am creating a record group. I am selecting as a character product ID based on that. It is populate group, I am populating the group. Populate list is a built-in one function. In this function, product ID, this ID is nothing but this is my product ID is my list item name, this list item name. This is nothing but my list item name. This way I can give in the command line, product ID is list item name in the form. This is what my product ID. This is what the, this product D1 is nothing but my group ID name. My record group name. This is a built-in function, brittle function available in the Oracle. That's what I did it here. So after once I did it, this created, this is procedure. I'll create the procedure. Then how I am calling this procedure is when new form instance, you can see here in the PLSQL operator, I am calling this procedures dynamic list item. This is I'm just calling. That's what I'm doing it. Then again I'm running. This way it's coming. Whenever I am running this, now you can say product ID, I am getting the information. Whatever the information, I am getting here in the product ID. So this way I am getting the list item here. This is called the dynamic list item values. That's what I given. I am explaining this query also. So the dynamic list item, very important thing is, don't need to create anything. So in the list item, no need to create the master and detail table, and it is not a data item. It should be list item should be there. No list values needed. So I will get the values from the database. So from the database only I am creating a group. That's why from the database getting, I am creating a group here. This create group, what I am doing is find the values from the database. So it automatically take the value from the database. So I am not writing anything. That's why I am selecting, select product name. I select the product name from the table product. This is what dynamic list item.